So I have here a very simple application which displays a list of messages which I'm fetching using Apollo client 3 and a form which is used to post a message. So the goal here is to have that message after the successful form submission displayed as a last item on the list. This is not the case as of now because after the form submission I'm not performing any kind of state or UI updates. So user would have to refresh the page to see his last message. I'm using use query hook to get the message's data and use mutation hook to post the message to my backend. All the logic happens in the handle on message function, which takes a message's content as a parameter. If you are familiar with Apollo client, you probably know that in situations like this one, you would use an update function to perform a query update with the data returned by the mutation. An update function is a special function which takes a cache instance and the data which was returned by the mutation. And before Apollo client 3, you would use cache read query API and cache write query API to perform the update. While this method is still very valid, Apollo client 3 exposes different APIs which can make this whole process of updating the query just a tiny bit less verbose. First thing we have to do is to get the cache ID under which our data returned from the mutation was saved. We can do this using cache.identify API, and we have to specify the data we want to identify. So in our case, a message. Next, we can use cache.modify API to perform the cache update. It expects us to specify fields which we want to modify. In our case, we want to update the messages field. Now, Apollo expects me to provide a modifier function. It is a special function which gets an existing field data and an object which contains different utility functions which can help you with modifying your field. In our case, we are interested in toReference function. Now, all we have to do is to just return existing field data and create a reference to the cache ID which we specified earlier. And now when we save, our application should work as expected. User can submit the message and that message will be instantly visible as the last message on the messages list.